Good day, everyone. I just want to give you a couple of perspectives as those of you that have seen that at 5 o'clock this morning, the parliamentary precinct caught a light, and there will be many investigations into why this happened, how this happened, and I'm going to give you a brief explanation with regards to a couple of things you should remember. That is very important. Now, I have extensive experience in firefighting training. I was a trained firefighter up to level 3 and a fire team leader for 7 years. So I was trained in command and control of traffic accidents, of building fires, and very complex situations. So hearing that the fire supply valves were shut when they are actually normally locked open and chained with padlocks to make sure that someone cannot inadvertently shut them is very disconcerting. And the second thing is the fact that the response to something like that should happen really fast in a national key point. So at a national key point, you should have staff on duty that should be trained in firefighting, that should be able to take care of a situation like that quickly. And they should be able to detect the fire in no time. And with all of that in mind, I have to ask myself, why did this happen? Why did this happen now? And I'm not going to go into that detail now. What I do want to tell you is that the National Assembly is not a building. The National Assembly are people. Okay, so it's important to understand that in the current electoral system, which is a proportional system, parties are voted for. The parties choose beforehand people. They put on a list that go to the National Assembly. And there's 400 parliamentarians. And from there, they elect the president of the country. I'm completely against the system. I have a huge problem with the system, and we are trying to change the system. But the parliament and the parliamentarians, they are people. So parliament can take place anywhere. You can put them in a rugby stadium or wherever. You can continue with parliament in any house, and I believe the mayor of Cape Town, Jordan Neil Lewis, has offered the council chambers for the State of the Nation address to continue. I have no idea what's going to happen going forward. And I only learned about the fire at Parliament about an hour ago, to be honest, because I don't sit and watch social media all the time. So the first thing I want you to know is that the country doesn't come to a standstill. Parliament doesn't come to a standstill because of a fire in a building. A building is a building. It might be historic. It might have to a lot of people, very important artifacts, beautiful art, etc. I've been to the parliamentary buildings, I've been to the old buildings for energy committee meetings. I've been to the normal parliamentary building, so is my wife. And, you know, to lose something like that is always sad. And things like that shouldn't happen. And if you look at the root cause of anything, you will find that what happened at Parliament probably resembles the state of the nation right now. And, you know, a lot of people have said to me, wow, Desmond, you said that this year will get off to quite a start. A lot of things will happen. I didn't expect this to happen at all. I don't have a crystal ball. All I can tell you is that as things evolve now, what's important is to see how the media plays this, how they use this, and then you will see the actual motive behind an event. Was it just an accident? Was there electrical wiring fault or whatever? Was a fire set? I hear that a person was arrested, but we have no idea what the circumstances are. They might want a scapegoat at this stage. You know, one person shouldn't be able to burn down an entire building like that. It shouldn't be possible at all. And the way the fire systems are put in, it shouldn't be possible for you to just go and isolate all the valves. So I think there will be an investigation, and then let's see what we hear. And based on what we hear, I will update you as time goes by and see what the actual intent, if any, is behind this fire, or whether it is just purely an accident, which is absolutely possible, considering the age of the building, etc. So only time will tell, but just understand one thing. Stability in the country is the most important thing. And the National Assembly, they are people. They can meet anywhere where the Speaker of Parliament agrees to meet, and the normal business of the country can continue in this current messed up system that I don't believe in at all and that I want to change. But it's important for you to understand that a parliamentary building and precinct burning down does not stop the function of government. Thank you very much for watching this video. Till the next video.